Hello, I'm Margaret Holmes, the author of A Terrible Thing Happened. This book includes a note to parents and caregivers written by my friend Sasha, Mudlaff. You'll meet her at the end of the story. It's illustrated by Carrie Pillow and published by Magination Press, the children's book imprint of the American Psychological Association. This is Sherman Smith, and he saw a terrible thing. Some of his thoughts and feelings are in the book. If you have some of the same feelings and thoughts, I hope his story will help you feel better. A terrible thing happened. Sherman Smith saw the most terrible thing. He was very upset. It really scared Sherman to see such a terrible thing. Sherman did not like feeling so afraid. He did not want to remember what happened. So Sherman decided not to think about the terrible thing that he saw. Sherman thought that would make him feel better. At first, his plan seemed to work. Sherman woke up every morning, he brushed his teeth, and he went to school. Sherman played with his friends, he teased his sister, and he walked his dog. Everything seemed to be all right for a while, but something inside of Sherman was starting to bother him. Sherman had to play more, run faster, and sing louder in order to forget the terrible thing he saw. Other things started happening to Sherman, too. Sometimes he did not feel hungry. Sometimes his stomach hurt or his head hurt. Sometimes he felt sad, but he did not know why. Sometimes he was nervous for no reason at all. Sometimes he did not sleep very well. Sometimes when he did sleep, he had very bad dreams. The bad dreams scared Sherman. All of these things made Sherman angry. It seemed like Sherman was angry all the time. Sherman started getting into trouble at school. Sometimes he felt so angry that he did mean things. Getting into trouble so often made Sherman feel bad. Sherman did not understand all of his bad feelings. He felt confused. Sometimes parents help children figure out their feelings. Sometimes teachers or other grown-ups help. That is how Sherman met Miss Maple. Miss Maple helped Sherman think about his feelings. She listened while Sherman talked. They played while they talked. Sherman did not feel as mixed up when he talked to Miss Maple. Once, when Sherman and Miss Maple were coloring, she told him to draw a picture of how he felt when he was angry. This seemed like a strange thing to draw, but Sherman did it. After that, Sherman drew lots of pictures. Pictures of the pain in his stomach, pictures of the bad dreams he had, pictures of the fear he felt. And at last, pictures of the terrible thing he saw. Sherman and Miss Maple talked about the pictures. He asked if the terrible thing he saw was his fault. Sherman said he worried a lot about that. No, Miss Maple told Sherman, it was not your fault. Sherman told Miss Maple a lot of things. He told her about the bad dreams. He told her how scared he felt. It was all very hard to do. Miss Maple was proud that Sherman was trying to talk about such hard things. Sherman found that it felt good to let his feelings out. Feeling good helped Sherman feel stronger. When Sherman felt stronger, he did not feel so angry. Nothing can change the terrible thing that Sherman saw, but now he does not feel so mean. He is not so scared or worried. His stomach does not hurt as much, and the bad dreams hardly ever happen. Sherman Smith is feeling much better now. He just thought you would want to know.
Hi, everyone. It's Sasha again. I'm Margaret's friend, and she asked me to talk to you about a really cool activity you might be able to do after reading A Terrible Thing Happened. You know that Sherman saw a terrible thing, and we're not sure what that is. Maybe you've seen or experienced a terrible thing too, and this book could really help you talk through that with someone that you love and trust. This activity is a cool thing because it gives you an opportunity to think about how could you help your friend who maybe they're going through a hard time or they've had a terrible thing happen. And so there's an attachment where that you can click on, and maybe you can print it. And if not, you could make your own on a piece of paper, draw a bunch of hearts. And inside each of the hearts, you can write ideas you might have of how to help a friend. So this says, how can we help our friends or ourselves if we were going through a tough time? And then you can see one of our favorite illustrations from A Terrible Thing Happened. There's Sherman with his friends. And you can write your ideas in here. So we hope this is helpful for you. And maybe you can be a good helper to one of your friends. Thanks, guys. Bye.